to Thursday Night SmackDown. Seth Rollins arriving here at the Thursday Night SmackDown without the WWE World Title.
What is wrong with this picture? Look at this. He's without the World Heavyweight Championship. He's without J&J Security. He's even without the Authority.
Well, we found out this past Sunday at Elimination Chamber, Dean Ambrose absconding with the WWE World Title, and then Monday Night on Raw, leveraging the Authority into a ladder match for the title at Money in the Bank. It was Roman Reigns that got the Authority to make them bend and make a decision under duress, but ultimately, Byron, it was Seth Rollins who accepted the rematch.
It just shows you how much this whole situation involving Dean Ambrose has gotten under the skin of Seth Rollins.
Nearly a year ago to the day, I took a chair, not unlike this one, and I single-handedly dismantled the Shield. Since that day, the question I've gotten from you people more than any question maybe I've ever been asked in my entire life is why? Why, Seth, why did you take that chair and use it to send a message to Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose? Why, Seth, did you destroy what you created? From day one, I said that my goal was to be the very best in the history of this industry. Not one of the best, the best. And I was getting sick and tired of sharing the spotlight with two chumps who were obviously beneath me. It was time to move on. And I was the only one who had the guts to pull the trigger. So I joined up with the Authority and they anointed me the undisputed future of the WWE. And I validated that endorsement by winning the Money in the Bank contract all by myself. The best part is that I was only getting started. Shortly after the Royal Rumble, I had a vision. I had a vision to make history, to do the impossible, to beat Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar at the same time. Now, it's one thing to come up with a plan like that, but to execute it flawlessly took courage, took guts, it took the heart of a champion. At WrestleMania, I ripped Roman Reigns' dreams right from his hands, and I slayed the beast at the same time. And now that beast is off somewhere licking his wounds while Roman Reigns is living in my shadow trying to recreate what I've done over the past year. But here's some news, brother. The sequel is never as good as the original. So here I stand, the greatest WWE World Heavyweight Champion of all time. And I've got no championship around my waist. Which brings me to Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose wants so desperately for all of you to think that he actually believes that stealing a championship will make him a champion. But Ambrose knows that that's not true. All of you know who the rightful champion really is. But you know what? That's fine, Dean. Play your little games, because I don't need any championship belt. I don't need anyone or anything to validate who I am and what I'm capable of. Now, I appreciate everything the authority has done for me. I really do. But I don't need J&J Security. I don't need Kane. I don't need The Big Show, I don't need Stephanie McMahon, and I don't need Triple H to destroy Dean Ambrose.